woman?
Yes.
Okay, so look what happens when she goes home. Verse 36. Now Abigail went to Nabal, and there he was, holding a feast in his house, like the feast of a king. And Nabal's heart was what? Merry within him, for he was very drunk. Therefore she told him nothing, little or much, until morning light. So now, he was a scoundrel, right?
Mm-hmm.
She knows it, right?
Mm-hmm.
She just saved his life, right?
Mm-hmm.
But when she saw her husband messed up, did she start badgering him right then and there? Mm-hmm. So what did she use? Wisdom. Some of you ladies got to use wisdom, and men also, when to speak. Even though you just saved their life, shut your mouth. But I got to tell them, I just saved his life, but you don't know what I did, right? Take the whole, hit it, relax on that. She waited until the next morning on that, okay? Some of you are looking at me, don't know what it is, but someone definitely knows what I'm talking about. When we come home messed up, they're going to pile you more into the ground in regards to that, okay? Verse 37. So it was in the morning when the wine had gone from Nabal, and his wife had told him these things, that his heart died within him, and he became like a stone. Have you ever heard some news, and your heart like stops beating, and you become like a stone? Yeah, if you haven't, good. That's not a good feeling. In regards to some of us, again, that's not a good feeling, all right? And look what happened, verse 38. Then it happened after about 10 days, that the Lord struck Nabal, and he died. Did David have to avenge himself?
No.
What happened to Nabal? That's it, right? Okay. Your enemies, don't avenge yourself. Leave it in God's hands. He's going to handle it. But now don't say, God, you killed Nabal, kill this one. Don't say that. I also say, God, bless that one in Jesus' name. Amen. Verse 39. So when David heard that Nabal was dead, he said, blessed be the Lord who has pleaded the cause of my reproach from the hand of Nabal and has kept his servant from evil. For the Lord has returned the wickedness of Nabal on his own head. And Nabal said, and what did he do, ladies? He proposed to Abigail to take her as his wife.
Oh, wow.
Look at that. What day you're married to a scoundrel, the next day you're married to a king. You know, okay? Because he showed wisdom. Okay? Okay, verse 30 to verse 40. When the servants of David had come to Abigail at Carmel, they spoke to her, saying, David sent us to you to ask you to become his wife. Verse 41, then she arose, bowed her face to the earth, and said, here is your maidservant, a servant to wash the feet of the servant of my Lord. So men, bring pedicures for us. It's not just to be kept, but give us pedicures. Okay, verse 42, so Abigail rose in haste and rode on a donkey, attended by five maidens, not one servant that she had. Five maidens, and she followed the messengers of David and became his wife. So we have to see how in this story that because of anger, David could have blown his kingdom before it even started. Some of us are blowing our ministries, or the devil wants us to blow our ministries before they get started. Hudson Church is a new ministry right now, and the devil is trying to blow you out of here before it even gets started. On there. So we have to have wisdom and understand it that it can happen in a split moment when we allow our anger, like King David, he said, I was going to kill everybody in regards to that. So please have the Holy Spirit engraft this into your hearts in Jesus' name. Amen. So now, the devil wants to do the same to us, rob us of our blessings. Rob us of our blessings in church. Do I get an amen on that?
Amen.
At home, does he want to rob us of our blessings? At work, something happens, I'm going to tell that boss a piece of my mind. You're fired in regards to that. So at work, so be on guard for Satan's tricks in Jesus' name. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. So now, reflect on the story. Take a pause before you respond. One more time. Reflect on this story and take a pause before you respond. Pray in the Holy Ghost and do not let your flesh respond, but instead your spirit. Let the Spirit of God lead you and guide you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen? So now, some practical things. From this moment forward, especially this time, a soft answer turns away wrath. Okay, a soft response. So Proverbs 15, verse 1. Ready, go. A soft answer, everybody, turns away wrath. But harsh words stir up anger. So if somebody talks to you bad, don't think that I automatically got to talk to them bad. Talk to them softer. They talk to you even more words, you come even more softer. That's going to throw them out. They're not going to know what to do with us when we respond that way. But if we respond, they're loud, we're loud, they're loud, you're loud. That's what they expect. Do it differently in Jesus' name. Amen?
Amen.
Proverbs 25, verse 15. By long forbearance and calmness of spirit, a judge or ruler is persuaded. And soft speech breaks down the most bone-like resistance. Amen. So as we go into our family situations, when we go into what's going to happen, bring it down instead of bringing it up, our responses in Jesus' name. Do you receive that?
Amen.
Amen. So now, question. How many of us, as we're getting ready to finish, how many say hallelujah, is getting ready to shut up? Look at that.
The importance of the heart, the mouth speaks.
It's all right, how many here have been robbed or stolen by Satan through anger? How many? Through anger. Okay, so not talking about just through anger, okay? That we've been robbed through anger. So it's important for us to realize that it ain't going to happen again this year. I'm not going to let anger rob me of my blessings in Jesus' name. So the good news is that God will restore everything back to us that the enemy has stolen, if you heed this word. Amen? He's going to restore. Joel chapter 2, verse 25, let's all read. And I will restore or replace for you the years that the locust has eaten, the hopping locust, the stripping locust, and the crawling locust, my great army which I sent among you. Verse 26. And you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied and praise the name of the Lord your God who has dealt wondrously with you. And my people shall never be put to shame. 27. And you shall know, understand, and realize that I am in the midst of Israel. Did we hear that word yesterday, folks? I'm in the midst of Israel, and that I, the Lord, am your God, and there is none else. My people shall never be put to shame. Proverbs 6, verse 31. This is only for those who have gotten something stolen from you. If no one has stolen from you, this is not for you. Is this for all of us? All right. Proverbs 6, verse 30 from the Amplified. Men, do not despise a thief if he steals to satisfy himself when he is hungry. Verse 31. But if he is found out, he must restore seven times what he stole. He must give the whole substance of his house, if necessary, to meet his fine. So everything that the devil has stolen from us throughout our lives, if you grew up without a parent, what are you stolen from? Mm-hmm. Yes, you were robbed from that relationship. Do you understand that? And if you lost a child, if you lost a bit, whatever it may be, you have a right to receive sevenfold recompense.
Amen.
By faith in Jesus' name. But you have to activate this right and not lose your cool and let anger rob you from this in Jesus' name. Amen?
Amen.
Another one. Job 42. Okay? We talk about Job. I like this verse in Job. Let's all read. And the Lord restored Job's losses. When he prayed for his friends. Not when he prayed for himself. He prayed for his friends. Indeed, the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before, man. The double-fold recompense. Verse 11. And all his brothers, all his sisters, and all those who had been his acquaintances before came to him and ate food with him in his house. And what type of house was that be? A little house with two little seats on there? And you only had two friends? When you're talking about this? So imagine you have a house and you can eat and fill up all these people coming into your house, all right? And they consulted and comforted him for all the adversity that the Lord had brought upon him. Each one gave him a piece of silver and each a ring of gold. So there's 30 people here, I need 30 pieces of silver, and 30 rings of gold, and 24 karat gold, not no 10 karat gold stuff. Okay, ready? So now the Lord blessed the latter days of Job more than his beginning. For he had 14,000 sheep, 6,000 camels, 1,000 yoke of oxen, and 1,000 female donkeys. Verse 13. He also had 7 sons and 3 daughters. How many of his children died? 10 of them. God gave him 10 more kids back there. Somebody said, God, I had those 10 for a while. It's good on that one. That could be enough for me. Don't give me no more 10. But he gave him 10 more. And look what he gave. Some of you missed that one at that point. When I was young, I wanted to have more kids. Younger, not young. Now I said, man, that's crazy. Thank you, God, for not responding to that. Alexis and Renee, easy enough. He said, then he gave me all of you as spiritual children in regards to that. I used to say, my father had me at 50. I said, when I'm 50, I'm going to have one more. But no. Okay, so now, in all the land were found no woman as beautiful as the daughters of Job. And their father gave them inheritance among their brothers. Drop down to 16, go. After this, Job lived 140 years. After this, so he can enjoy everything that God has for him, okay? And he saw his children and grandchildren for 4 generations. 140 years of enjoying the goodness of God on his life. Verse 17, so Job died old and full of days. Amen? So Hudson Church, let us use God's wisdom. And let us use more of God's wisdom. As we leave this place today, I ask the Holy Spirit to guide and counsel every one of us within the sound of my voice, not to fall for the devil's lies anymore in Jesus' name. Can I get an amen on that?
Amen.
When the tests come our way, and they will come, they told you the tests are coming in a little while, wherever we're going now. The tests are coming to rob this word, to rob your blessing. They're coming, folks. Don't think that they're not coming, okay? So when the tests come, let us pass them by not allowing ourselves to get angry and lose our blessings. Amen?
Amen.
So we leave with this. Enjoy your lives. Enjoy your families. Enjoy your church. And most of all, enjoy our Lord Jesus the Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So praise God. Let's stop the thief in Jesus' name. Amen. All head bowed, all eyes closed. We have 3 invitations for this morning. If these invitations pertain.